tell
those
stories.
Cinderella stories. Those things are not real. Even Disney realizes it's not real. That's why you see Frozen ended the way it did. Shrek ended the way it did.
Exactly.
They started changing the stage.
The narrative.
You don't just meet someone and, oh, we're getting married tomorrow. They know that these things are unrealistic and children are growing up with those expectations.
Yeah, exactly. Woo-hoo! You guys know I don't do anything without my big tail hand sanitizers. Especially in these days of viruses.
Yes.
You have to use. Exactly. You know how finicky I am about germs and stuff still.
So nice. It feels so good.
And I love the aloe smell.
Oh.
Nice. Anywho. Hello, darling. How are you guys all doing today? Welcome back to another video. So in today's video, I have my big sister, Deansy.
Yes.
In my video, drum roll. I guess who this is. Ta-da! Bassy. Yeah. So in today's video, I have my... Oh,
I know what you're saying.
Why do you look like that? So in today's video, we're going to be talking about something very interesting. Well, I always call my topics interesting because they are interesting. Take that to the bank.
Yes.
So today's video, I know Valentine's is around the corner. We're going to be talking about reasons why you're single on Valentine's Day. Obviously, we just mean like reasons why you are single. It doesn't have to be around Valentine's Day. Don't get me wrong, there's nothing wrong with being single. Some of the best times in life is when you're single and focusing on yourself.
I know, right?
But I mean like great people can share themselves with other great people. But why are you not sharing yourself with a great person? So we have a few tips and tricks, and we feel like if you do or tweak a few things here and there, you definitely find yourself with great partners and, you know, be able to, because there's joy in companionship, there's joy in having a partner that celebrates you, right? There's joy in having someone.
Can have
a
cat, a dog, not a companion, and to celebrate you. See,
when
you give good food.
In this video, we are talking about human beings. So these are the reasons why you're single on Valentine's Day and lonely and drinking champagne alone if you have it, when you should be out having fun. Now, my first tip is, why are you guys so quiet?
We're waiting for you now.
Oh, okay. So my first personal tip is you never go anywhere. Like, your friends call you to hang out, you never want to go out, you never want to work, you don't want to hang out with your colleagues after work, you don't want to go to places and meet people, you're just like a couch potato. There's nothing wrong with being a couch potato, but you're never going to meet any other person.
There's
being
something
a couch
wrong
potato.
You don't burn calories being a couch potato.
Exactly, you can get fat, like
literally be round like a potato.
Exactly. Right? So like
no
you're
offense to potatoes, just saying.
No, fat shaming, because I'm fat, so we can't fat shame.
Why not fat shaming? We're potato shaming.
Why? I like potatoes.
No, I like potatoes.
Okay,
no,
I don't like potatoes.
Right.
Okay.
I like potatoes.
Okay, sorry, potatoes.
Yeah, exactly.
No, potatoes.
So like, you don't want to mingle, you don't want to go out, you don't want to network, you're just by yourself all the time. Mm-hmm. I know you can meet people online, but it's never the same as physical interactions and talking to people, mingling and everything. But I mean, that's my first
online, right?
But the, you see, you can't marry online. You have to meet the person. It has to be a physical interaction. People do that, but I mean,
why do you look perfect? Like
safe,
I'm
riskless.
That's
a risk I wouldn't
take. The person. Wow, that's brave.
Yeah.
That's very brave. That's a risk I will never take. And no matter what happens, no matter how you feel close to a person online, it can never really be the same as physical interaction. So that's that for that. So what's your first point?
My first
fear of commitment is the first point.
So fear
of heartbreak. Or some people, it's not, maybe they've been there, done that, had this bad experience, so
I think you should take it one per time. First of all, it's fear of commitment.
Fear of commitment.
Okay, well,
so you define fear of commitment.
Exactly.
It's
so, okay.
The fear of
commitment.
So the fear of you not wanting to share yourself, like the fear of you not wanting to be, yes, to put yourself out there, the fear of you not wanting to be accountable to someone else, the fear of you not wanting to be thinking about someone else, the fear of you not wanting to worry and bother about someone else, I think that is fear of commitment. Like you just really like your own space, you don't want to share it or give it to another person.
Borderline selfish.
Yeah,
right?
Exactly. You don't want to share.
You all have the point. That's right.
So because like you've been heartbroken before, so you don't want to put yourself out there anymore. You don't want to risk being hurt again. It's a valid fear. I agree with you. Like, it's not easy to overcome. It takes time for you to heal properly after a heartbreak. So it's a valid fear.
Very
I mean, you have to get over yourself.
Have you ever had a heartbreak back?
Me?
Yes.
Or you've been breaking people's hearts?
Man.
Yeah, or you've been
you
breaking.
Know,
because this one that you can't
even talk about the fear of heartbreak. You're just so...
It doesn't mean I haven't been heartbroken before. I lost my homeboy one time, you know. He died in a crash, so that was heartbreaking.
Yeah. So, but then that doesn't stop you from making friends. Do you understand?
So it's kind
of, so
Sure.
You can't use the fear of the past to control your future. You just have
True
to
that.
Put yourself out there. You just have to take risks.
You have,
to risk falling in love.
That's like saying because accidents happen, you're never going to enter a car. You're never going
exactly.
to
exactly because you,
people think that relationships
are expensive.
Yeah,
and they could be, to be honest.
Spending money.
It, but
like,
it does.
You have to go out on dates. You have to buy
full credits for the
iPhone 11.
Yes, you're right.
You have to buy data.
Mobile data. Yeah, exactly. So yeah. Some people are not financially ready for.
But who says you have to have money to be in a relationship? Do you? Don't broke people or poor people or people who don't have so much money. Are they not in relationships and are they not happy?
Right. It's a good point right there. You're right.
I think it depends on who you're dating.
No, so but then you can't define your happiness.
Some people are higher maintenance than other people. When it comes to relationships. Like for instance, I might request like maybe we live in different countries. I might want to see you every other month. Another person might be good seeing you once a year because they understand your financial situation.
True.
But at the same time, it's still monetary commitment. No matter how you're going to pay taxes on to go on dates. You're going to buy.
Okay, so what happens to the kids when you didn't plan it? You guys were both in Nigeria, for example, and then one partner now has a job and is transferred, let's say after 1 year, to another country. Suddenly the relationship becomes expensive. Do you now break up because, oh, I can't afford a ticket to see this person every other month?
Sometimes that actually happens. But I mean, I think it depends on how far you've got in the relationship. Like, if you have already built a foundation, then you've already done the things that already make the relationship on a certain level. You don't need to do all those maybe monthly visits.
Maybe you do, because sometimes some people, out of sight is out of mind, right? So
sure.
Some people like to be seen, to have that physical bonding, to know that, oh, I still have this person in my corner, we're still together. But that whole distance thing, yes, distance makes the heart grow fonder, but I think at some point.
But when it's too much, it's too much.
Yeah, exactly.
And there's something like too much distance, that's what I think.
I think so.
Okay, so
the distance can be an excuse anyway.
Say something.
Say, say we're listening.
What I've done, I'm not going to do.
Okay, so you
say that.
So basically, I think the problem is that most people are not just being realistic. This pressure from, I mean, the social media and you know, your friends and whatnot. And then people like to tell you about their experiences and what they
and what to do. They feel like they know best
and whatnot. And then you have all these expectations and all this criteria and, you know, and what you think the other person is supposed to be to, you know, get you talking to them or going on second dates or trying to give it a chance.
Yeah.
And you end up just either getting
frustrated, disappointed.
Because you're going to meet a lot of people who come out pretending to be something that they're not.
And at the end of the day, you realize that they're human.
You go around in circles and then circles and you find yourself alone.
And because you're looking for that perfect ideal.
Which really sometimes.
So, society standards.
Yeah, sometimes.
Society
pressure,
or even personal standards. Like
social media pressure, peer pressure.
Yeah, I think it's like society pressure in general.
Yeah, generally. I want to date a man that has a Mercedes Benz and lives in a Benz.
Exactly. True.
Stuff.
So, when you have a wrong perception of what a relationship should be like.
And this colleague of mine who's earning what? Oh, I know how much he's earning, and he's doing pretty okay. Mm. But nah, he doesn't have a Mercedes. Drives a Camry, so that's not gonna work.
Yeah, exactly.
I want this, you know, like Ronke's boyfriend. Oh my god.
Yeah,
they went to Dubai
together
and stuff like that. So you see, these are some of the issues in relationships.
Yeah, I think I want to add to what you're saying. It's like setting unrealistic standards for yourself.
Of course.
Like wanting a man that can buy you a G-Wagon and take you on exotic vacations when you can't even do it for yourself.
I mean, there's nothing wrong with wanting the final thing in
life.
It's just that.
But I think judging someone that doesn't have it
without even getting to know
when you yourself can't do it for yourself
is
a bad thing.
Focusing more on people being a little bit too materialistic. You know, looking out for these material things to define what your ideal man is supposed to be like.
Mm-hmm.
When you can actually, you know, sit down with some young fella and hold a good conversation.
And
then listen to what they have to say and connect on that level. And maybe something good might come along.
I think I agree.
Yeah.
I mean, there's nothing wrong with having...
expectations. You must have good, like, have a good job.
But is it bad to have those material expectations?
There's nothing wrong with it. But you know, how many of these people around are made... ready-made people.
Exactly, especially
that's
at your age,
you know,
level.
You have to be ready to build with somebody that is coming up. As long as you know you can discern that they actually have something, you know.
They have like a purpose.
They have
a vision.
So you have a future. We have them.
Prospects.
Although those people that come with prospects and
those prospects never turn to anything.
Those funny prospects.
So you see now, prospects will not work. So people want what is already made.
Prospects backed up by action.
They don't believe in the prospects.
No, I think prospects backed up by action.
I mean,
right?
Yeah, that too.
Because you can't be telling me prospect, and then I see you morning to night. You're sleeping. You're not doing anything. You're not hustling. I'm not gonna eat prospects. 10 years time. I want to see prospects with hard work. So prospect backed up by hard work.
And I think it should come both ways. So if I have a list, oh, he must drive a G-Wagon, he must have a house in.
Then you should be able to buy a house for yourself.
He must have like, he must be able to take like 12 trips abroad.
He
must be able to buy me $350,000 a week.
You know, like all those funny things. So that's what we're saying. The materialistic standards that people set for themselves, like my bills won't pay themselves. My rent.
Exactly. I need a man who is rich. But you're not even rich.
But you're not even looking at, okay, so I come with a G-Wagon, I come with a fancy house, I come with fancy gifts and all those things, but underneath it all, I don't.
Really? Go ahead, sorry.
You know what? You know?
Yeah.
And underneath it all, I don't have the quality of a human, like my human quality isn't up there. It doesn't match. I'm not saying that people who have G-Wagons don't necessarily have good qualities. I'm just saying that
you're looking out for the wrong thing.
Beyond that,
she's hating on G-Wagons.
Yeah, no. I actually hate G-Wagons.
Well, my first time,
you get my point, right? That's the point, is just look beyond what is in your face to what is, well, beyond your face. In the sense that you need to still get to know the person. Even if the person is coming with a G-Wagon and a fancy house, you have to still know what does that person bring to the table in addition to
the
thing. And besides, the person that has a G-Wagon today may have nothing tomorrow.
Life exactly.
Is weird like that, right? Anything
True.
Can just flip over
True.
And then you get
Or you'll have a Ferrari tomorrow.
Oh, you can go that way.
Okay, what I'm saying is this. I'm not saying that there's anything wrong with trying aim for someone that is sitting well in the society, or you know, is doing pretty well for themselves. I mean, that's the dream of everybody. Like, you have to, you know, want to your partner to be somewhere. But I think that the main focus here should be getting to know them, their personalities, and that should not be a limiting factor. Because if you're actually looking for these made guys, huh? I mean, how many are they?
And how many can have them,
you
know? Right?
Yeah. You should look for what you can give.
Yeah, I think you should.
So you're saying if you want a girl that's got a big ass, you as a man should have a big ass too?
No, I mean, what you're talking about bringing something to the table, if you have certain physical characteristics, you yourself should be of a physical standard.
What is physical standard
now? It's so relative. No, but it's so relative. But you should have physical standards that are also attractive. You can't tell me you want a Rihanna shaped girl, but you are like pot bellied and slouchy.
But maybe the Rihanna shaped girl likes a pot bellied man now. So
with money in the bank, yeah.
But at least you satisfy the fact that you are physically attractive to yourself before looking for someone who is physically attractive to others. Do you understand?
Yeah. No, but you just like just be comfortable in your own skin. Yeah. It's not about how they look or what they look like. It's just about the fact that, I mean, physical appearance isn't. It's just if you're attracted to somebody, I think it goes beyond what they look like. There's something that draws you to somebody else, and you think that it's physical, but sometimes I think it's slightly beyond that. And the physical thing goes away after some time, but something needs to sustain it. Otherwise,
exactly, when you're 60 and old and everybody's slouching and sagging.
One night stand happened.
I just think what we're trying to say
is
look for what you can't give.
Okay.
But people look for what they can't give.
But I don't appreciate you sitting
for
down.
For example, an introvert looks for an extrovert to date.
No, you're looking for someone to compliment you.
So now,
you're looking for someone to compliment you.
No, never look for someone. Nobody can.
But not that you're like poor, you're dirt poor. You can't even afford like 1,000 naira. You're looking for someone who will take your vacations every month. I think that's unrealistic expectations. Yeah. It's not bad to want it.
It happens.
But it's bad to judge everybody that approaches you because they don't have it.
You can't buy me data.
Exactly. So I'm not going to date you. Like that's
refill
just
my,
you understand
refill,
that's just
refill my phone
I recharge my phone. Yeah, recharge my phone.
So but I mean there's nothing wrong with asking for something good, I'm trying to look out for the best for yourself, but I think that we should sometimes just come down off that high horse and try to get to know somebody for like, you know, good reasons. You can hold good conversations, you have good chemistry, you know, he dresses nice and he talks to you and treats you right. He or she treats you right, and that's the most important thing. And then, I know money is important, very important.
It is.
But I believe that if two people are serious about making things work, they will figure out a way
around. Yeah, true.
You know,
two heads are always, two good heads are always better than one.
Because sometimes in the course of looking for maybe Valentine's date or the perfect person, you might find someone who is perfect but in business for you, someone who ends up being your mentor, someone who's just a friend or like a brother.
Exactly. Or someone doesn't have
it, doesn't necessarily mean that it's only can still be something for you in some regard. Because even that so-called perfect person isn't a perfect human being. That person is just perfectly complements you, and it takes work and it takes time, and you're building and getting to know each other. That's really it. So forget what you see out there, and no matter how you aim for Beauty and the Beast or what are those?
Cinderella and fairy tale
those
stories.
Cinderella stories. Those things are not real. Even Disney realizes it's not real. That's why you see Frozen ended the way it did. Shrek ended the way it did.
Exactly.
Because they started changing the stage.
The narrative.
They don't just meet someone and, oh, we're getting married tomorrow. They know that these things are unrealistic and children are growing up with those expectations.
Yeah, exactly.
And so they're starting to change those narratives and redefine how people think. You don't just meet someone and fall in love and marry the person. Not everyone looks perfect on the outside. Case in point, Shrek. And different, you know, different things that happen. So don't look at what you see on TV or what you read in Emma. Do people still read Emma? Or 50 Shades of whatever and think that's how life works.
Nagu, you're gonna be disappointed.
Mm-hmm.
We said what we said. What we said is what we said.
Of course.
Do you have any more points?
I think pretty much it comes around those points.
Yeah, I think so. Yeah. And if we come up with more, we're gonna do a part two.
And there's no law that says you must be in a relationship.
Exactly.
Single, be happy.
Disclaimer.
Do you, boo.
Whatever makes you happy, please. If you like this video, don't forget to give us a big fat thumbs up.
Yeah.
Subscribe to this channel. Click the red button.
And believe happily ever
after. Button that looks this color. No, this is pink. Oh. Red.
Ho, ho, ho. Hello, darlings. Oh, should we say that?
Oh, okay. Hell no. You said